I have to personally say thank you for giving woodwinds a voice. I'm a clarinet player. So your music is so far reaching. Like I said, I've played, you know, versions of your music in high school pep band. Marching bands are playing your music for halftime shows. I mean, how does the impact that that has, that your music is still touching generations and you're seeing it on halftime field shows? Do you get a kick out of that?
Oh, yeah. When we originally wrote the songs, we had, you know, hopefully someone else would like it besides ourselves. and you know, so to have this kind of influence and so many different generations that enjoy the music, it's phenomenal.
When you guys were getting started, it was late 60s, very politically turbulent time. Here we are again in a very politically turbulent time. And I'm not trying to go political with you guys, but it was obviously very important. Songs like Dialogue and Harry Truman, and there was a bunch of stuff early on, environmental stuff, Mother. I mean, there was stuff out there that was blatantly political for the times.
Right.
Do you still do that stuff? Do you still have the feelings? Do you still have the passion? Or is it just smarter now to just kind of let the music go?
We play Dialogue every night.
Do you?
And it's amazing. That's a song that I really don't sing very much on, so I get to really listen to.
But you wrote
the
it,
lyric.
Didn't you?
Yeah,
he wrote it. Yeah.
To a large degree, unfortunately, everything I was writing about then is true now. Mm. So not very much has changed.
Mm. Wow.
Only now it's really crazy.
In fact, it's sort of uncanny how up to date the lyric is as much up to date then as it is right
still
now.
Still applies.
Yeah.
In your mind. Any band that's going to be together 50 years going through transitions. I mean, there were definitely transitions of band members. There were transitions of musical styles. There were transitions of all kinds. Do you look back at all and say, I didn't like that stuff as well as I like that stuff? Or, I mean, do you have favorites? Is there anything you did that you just didn't like? Or is it all kind of like your children? You like them all the same, just differently?
Pretty much. Pretty much. We have been so busy all the time throughout the entire 50 years that it's very difficult to stop and really do any retrospect as to see, you know, how did I feel back then? We're just continually moving forward.
The process of recording, you know, where the songs, the various guys who write bring the songs in, we rehearse them, we do the tracks, we start overdubbing. But the process of recording is really what vets what we think is pretty good.
Right.
Now, 10 years later, the opinions may vary a little bit. I mean, a lot of the music we recorded in the 80s was just screams. I mean, the audio profiles just screams 80s, where the loudest thing on the track is the drum,
is the
snare drum.
Yeah.
And it's an awful sound.
And not even a real drum, necessarily.
Well, speaking of styles and the change in sound, I mean, what do you think of music today? I mean, you talked about the 80s and drums, and now we're in a phase where everything seems to be auto-tuned.
Hmm. Yeah, too much is auto-tuned. I was actually sharing my opinion. I was listening to the top 10, and I have to say there wasn't one song in the top 10 that had a natural instrument in it. It had samples of instruments, but like barely any guitar, for instance. All sort of keyboard driven and synth driven and sequenced.
But there's people like Bruno Mars and Justin Timberlake who are very musical in every way, they incorporate all kinds, you know, everything.
And they're very good.
They're very good.
So you're fans.
Oh, yeah.
So you're not pessimistic that there are Chicago's and who else can I, I mean, singer-songwriters, James Taylor. I mean, you're not pessimistic that the future versions of those great acts aren't out there somewhere. I mean,
they're for sure out there.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Great. I think there's great singer-songwriters emerging all the time.